And with the playing of the Star Spangled Banner, we are set to get underway here for Winchester's home opener this week against Waltham. My name is Nikhil Karthikeyan, and alongside me here is Jason Termini, and we welcome you to this WinCam broadcast. Now, tonight, we got Winchester versus Waltham. For Winchester, the captains this year are going to be Ben Wilson, Emmett Goodrich, Harry Lowenstein, it's going to be Will Schlesinger, Quentin Johansson, and Caden Salvietti. For Waltham, the captains are number 1, Jack Renaud, number 3, Ty Connolly, number 4, Tony Farrow, and number 54, Alex Cabral.
All right, Nikhil, I'm actually pretty excited for this game because they're both coming off of straight wins, both off of Newton North and Newton South, and they both seem to have critiqued and revised their play styles just to adapt to each other, and I'm really excited to see what we're going to get here because both come up winner records. They both seem to have heavy pass games, and we're just getting ready to start off kickoff here, guys. Let's see here.
The kick from Waltham coming from Edwin Ramirez, senior at Waltham High. Last week, Winchester beat Newton South with a score of 13-6. And it's a short squib up the middle, recovered by Winchester. Cutting towards the middle and tackled around the 39-yard line, where your Winchester red and black will get underway here.
It's exciting to see. Honestly, like, the amount of freshmen here that we have here is great. Because
Evan Geyer on return for Winchester.
Derek Jancy, and he was amazing. But even because he was so good, is that he was used a lot of times and he made a lot of yard progressions. But the other teams were able to adapt to Derek Jancy, and they were able to capitalize off the run and keep on going for blitzing and man coverage.
Derek Jancy, of course, last year's senior, no longer with us. He's moved on to college. Well, there's number 10 in the pocket. It's Harry Lowenstein. Starts off with a quick dump off to Doucette, number 23 along the outside near the first down marker. And that should be a first down for Winchester. Good start to the game so far, just a quick dump off.
And that is good for a red and black first down.
It's always nice to see some small progressions like that, getting the first down. Ease into the game, you don't want to start off too hard, but good start.
Yeah, Nikhil, it's going to be some... The key to beating Waltham in this case is that they know what to do with the zone coverage, so you're going to have to go dink and dunk across the field in order to... So Harry Lowenstein combined with Doucette and maybe a bit of Wilson in there is definitely going to put a challenge to Waltham's defense.
Wilson lined up closer to us, number 4, the wide receiver for Winchester. Fake handoff to the side, but tackled for a loss there was Akira. Akira being the senior for Winchester.
Lowenstein's pass is complete to Caligniaro.
What I'm also noticing here, Nikhil, is a lot of the former quarterbacks that we saw
five
last
the play, second down and 15 for the red and black.
And that's going to be really good because I'm excited to see what they can play as it was on the receiving game.
Now offensive coordinator Tom Carr trying to shout some stuff to Lowenstein out there. Coach for Winchester is, of course, returning Walter Dombowski.
It looks like it's going to be a run here, a fake handoff. And Waltham's prepping here for his
Someone
zone
jumped
coverage.
On Waltham. And now Winchester jumps as well. Schlesinger on the outside, number 17, jumps.
False start, Winchester.
So that's going to set them back a bit. And now it's going to be second down and 20, which is in really bad position now.
This is going to force them to pass deep, and I think it's going to be a good time to finally show off some really nice receiving game here.
They're going to have to come up with something here. 20 yards to go. They have two downs before it's fourth. Otherwise, just another punt. Just like last year, we saw so much of it failing to convert the first downs, which is what they need to start doing, which they already have one first down so far. No one in the backfield. Lowenstein alone. They got five receivers out.
It's going to be a deep pass here, I believe. They have to go from the Winchester 39.
Motion, Doucette. And they're just going to throw it quickly to Doucette around the outside. And he fumbles the ball, and the ball tumbles out of bounds. So a lucky break for Winchester. That could have gone way worse. They're lucky that the ball went out of bounds. And that brings up third down and really long.
This is going to force, it's going to force the pass game. They're, Waltham is starting to adapt to the dink and dunk already, and that's going to show how fast-paced this game is going to go through. Like, we're going to see, I feel like this, what they're going to do here is, they, judging by Winchester being forced to pass, the, it seems that Waltham should go for some sort of zone coverage here, and judging by the looks of it, it looks kind of like it. I can't really tell from here, but it looks like it,
in motion,
there's
the
Kira going across the other side. And it's a fake throw now across to Ben Wilson. Wilson around the outside will be stopped at the 42. That'll bring up fourth down and a likely punt for Winchester, which should give Waltham
pick up a 10 on the play. That's going to bring up fourth down for the red and black.
Now out comes the punting unit for Winchester. Get to see who the punter is. It's going to be number 9, which is Kieran Core.
Kieran Core, I'm pretty sure he left last year and pursued soccer, so it's great to see him back on the football field in Harry Nolan Stadium.
Kiernor being the kicker. And it's a big punt down to the 25, returned by Waltham, number 7. There's Register along the left side, still going, and he's finally tackled out of bounds at the 35. Number 7, Josh Registre, the wide receiver, senior for Waltham.
Registre in the return for Waltham.
Now this offense on Waltham, I'm particularly excited to see because I've heard great things that they're very known for their deep balls and their chucks deep. Yep. But it seems to be a very boom or bust style here.
One of their captains is their quarterback. Number 1 is Jack Renaud, and he's probably going to be the play caller for the night. There he is with the rest of his offense. They have just a measly 35 yards to go for the end zone, so Winchester's going to have to clamp up here, or Waltham's going to go up early.
It looks like Winchester already prepared for the deep pass here. Look at that. It looks like it's going to be...
Ref's waving it off. There's been some sort of confusion.
Jones goes in here.
Defensive coordinator for your Winchester Red and Black is a combination of all their defensive coaches.
All right, it seems like the receivers are poised. All right, it's a fake, it's a handoff.
Handoff to number 3, there's Ty Connolly gets the
Ty
first Connolly down.
On the carry
down
for Waltham.
To the 18-yard line.
Good for,
and they only have 18 yards
down
to go now, so Winchester has to clamp up before they really have to clamp up now.
Yeah, Nikhil, it's... The thing I'm noticing with Winchester's defense is they're definitely, like, Waltham seems to be juking them a bit. It seems to be like a fake out every so often where it's like, oh, we're going for a deep pass. Oh, just kidding, it's a dink and dunk. Oh, maybe we're going for a run here. Oh, it's a, just kidding, it's a screen pass, it's a deep pass over 18-yard line. So we could see that here.
A quick handoff is stopped. Great defensive play from Winchester. That's 59. Liam Poole
on a takedown for Winchester.
Out of Winchester High.
And now it seems that Winchester's not having it. They are ready to stop Waltham here. It's like they let them go over a couple yards and say not having it here. We're stopping you here now. You can't do anything about it. We'll do everything in our power to stop you from here on out.
Out comes the Waltham unit again, back in. One back with quarterback. Snap is high. The snap's fumbled, and he's going to fall in it. And Waltham's going to lose a couple
fumble
of yards. And that brings up a big third down here. They don't convert. They're likely going to have to kick, and they might even elect to punt. So that's already great for Winchester.
The thing that might have, I feel like it might have scared the Waltham quarterback here, was Parker Nagadell's ability to just navigate through that offensive line.
Third down and 20
for the
Hawks.
Just jump the quarterback on Waltham, which I think is what got him there and scared him.
Drops back, and the refs blow their whistle. There's a flag. It's going to be a false start on the offense, so that's going to send it back 5 yards and bring up third down and 25.
It seems that a lot of the time, it seems that Winchester and Waltham's defenses are pulling back a lot, and they're doing darn well at it too.
More important thing here is it looks like Waltham's going to be just outside of field goal range here. So if they don't convert here or don't get a couple of yards, they're going to have to punt. Let's see if they can get those few yards. They got trips on the left, three wide receivers outside. Now one of them in motion is Connolly. Fake handoff to him. Steps back. The rush is coming. There's nobody there. That's incomplete.
Renault's pass is incomplete.
Close to an intentional
grounding. Fourth down for the Hawks.
But that brings up fourth down deep, and let's see what they do here.
Looks like they're current.
QB's still on the field, but now he's going to trot off, and here comes the special teams unit.
Now, at this point, I can only see one option here, obviously being the punt.
And it looks like they will bring out the punting unit. Number 11, that is Edwin Ramirez, their kicker.
Ben Wilson back deep for Winfield
here. They're putting that Winchester is kind of at a pretty advantageous stage here. If they get past, it's a pretty advantageous state here. Winchester has to get past the 50-yard line, and they're all
open. Snaps a little to the right, and he punts it up. And it's a good punt. It's going to bounce, rolling towards the goal line. And a great punt from the Waltham punter. That's going to pin Winchester inside their own five.
They take over on the 1 yard line.
Wow. It's a tough position for Lowenstein and crew to get started.
But
they're
going
to have to do it with 6:27 left in the first quarter.
That punt was down to perfection. You could see the ball rolling right at the almost at the perfect 1 yard line.
Yeah, the long snapper also kind of messed up there. The snap wasn't right to the punter. To the outside, punter at the shift. Great adjustment and great kick.
Please show your appreciation by demonstrating good sportsmanship and respect for all in attendance.
So Winchester's ready to go. Even right in the touchdown zone here. It looks like it's going to be a pass, as it should be, because it's out there.
Now, remember, if Winchester get tackled in their own end zone, that's a safety. 2 points for Waltham. A quick throw to the outside is draw.
Lowenstein's pass is incomplete.
He was looking for his favorite target, number 4, Ben Wilson, another junior. Both of them juniors at Winchester High.
We saw Ben Wilson last year. He had a couple of great catches in the deep end. They played, I believe they played Mask Numb, and then Ben Wilson got an amazing touchdown catch right on them. Right on their 40. They're deciding here. I think it's going to be it should be a pass. And it's like, I feel like it's going to be another dink and dunk to Wilson here, which is why I think they might be putting safety on him, but
I can't
confirm.
Down and 10 now, and flags fly again. Lots of flags flying. Looks like they were trying to draw an offsides on the defense, and it worked.
Offside.
So that'll push him up 5 yards, give him some more room to work with, not being pressed against their own goal line.
That's going to be a really important factor here, Nikhil. Just being able to get out and prevent the safety is going to help them in the long run, because in case they get the interception, in case they get that fumble, then it inevitably prevents Waltham from just going, and stepping 2 yards and then getting a touchdown. So that's going to be great for Winchester, and it's also going to give Winchester a lot more wiggle room and opportunity, because it's only 2nd and 5.
Snaps back, and it's a fake handoff, and Lowenstein goes by himself to the outside near the first down marker.
It'll
be just short, and that'll bring up 3rd down and 1. A great play call. Had the entire Waltham defense confused, except for a couple of linebackers who followed Lowenstein the entire time, prevented him from getting the first down.
Now, I saw this in the review. They went over this, and I got to see them talking about Lowenstein, his ability just to sneak by, and it shows right here. It's a perfect emphasis, and I hope we can see it more during this game, because it seems that it's a good card to pull, because they have so many different cards.
Quick motion before the snap. Two players shifting to the other side. Confusion on the Waltham defense, and it's a handoff. And he's stuffed just before the first down marker, and that should bring up 4th down and short. Now, this is a really risky situation to be going for it, so you'd think they'd punt it. And on comes the punting unit, number 9, Kieran Core, 2-kick it off. Kieran Core being the junior out of Winchester High School.
My only question is, like, they have They brought an entirely different unit here, which is understandable. But they also brought out some different receivers, which it might be a sign of a bit of action.
That would be balls.
That'd be very gutsy, and it'd be honestly quite eventful. I'd love it.
Snap is low. Core gets the punt up around the 40, and it's going to be returned by Connolly out to the right side. He's still going to the 15, where he's tackled out of bounds.
By
Patty Galfin, number 19.
That's at least a 20-yard receive. Wow. So Connolly's really good this. Wow, oh my gosh. It's
compared to last time, Waltham gets an even shorter field to work with to score a touchdown. Now they only have to go just less than 20 yards, just around 15 yards.
I think I'm guessing they're going to go for another dink and dunk or two before they truly, and trying to get some yards off of them before they can go in for a run of the touchdown. And Winchester has to prep for that, so they have to go for, like, say, a man coverage to prevent the dink and dunks and maybe a blitz to stop it. So,
yep, and there you go. They got man coverage out on the left side, so the left side of the field looking very open. Renaud to take the snap with two in the backfield. Gives it to one of them. There's Connolly. Connolly gets a couple of yards, stumbles at around the 10, and that should bring up second down around 4.
Good running here.
So they're already inside the 10-yard line. Now, if you're Winchester, what do you do here, Jason?
If I was Winchester here, I would just try to, because you had such little wiggle room, right? I'd try to put a safety or two in the backfield, and I just have everyone go in. So it's basically a blitz, but it's also a combination of man coverage, a little bit of zone coverage in the back. That's what I'd do here, unless it's going to be a run.
The run up the middle from Connolly, and he's stuffed, but that should be a first down, bringing up first down and goal at the 3-yard line.
I'm guessing it's going to be a touchdown.
First down, first and goal, Hawks.
It looks,
as long as they keep running, if they throw, it's risky.
It's going to be another run, Connolly here. Hand off to Connolly.
And he's still going, but Winchester's line able to keep him still. Giving it their all, trying to prevent him from getting to the end zone.
And Akil, the line is there. I feel like the line is really underestimated in this game. They have a ton of potential, and we've seen it here throughout the game.
And it looks like one of the Waltham players is hobbling off, number 2. That's Darren Duclos, who appears to be injured now. Now, if you're Waltham, the worst thing you can do here is take a penalty and set yourself back. That'd be the best case scenario for Winchester, of course. Snap is a little high, and it's a fake handoff. Quarterback keeps it, but he has nowhere to go, and he's stuffed by the Winchester defense. There's a safety, Will Schlesinger, number 17, coming together to make the play with 16, Jack Cinerelli.
And we'll talk about last time. The line is strictly underrated. If you underassume the line, it's almost a death wish. They'll get you in the company the least time you expect it, because you'll see the lineman just squinch over and just get inside the pocket and collapse it within.
Brings up third down and goal from the 9. You got one in the backfield now, and it's a fake handoff. And again, the quarterback has nowhere to go. He throws it, but he's not going to go anywhere. That's down at the 5. It brings up fourth down and goal. There is a flag. We'll see what the flag is, depending on what the flag is.
I think that was intended for Noah Pierre-Lewis. It looked like it was going to be a screen here, but again, third time now, the line is doing really well here. Even in this windy condition, the line's prepped, focused, and they know the feet, they know the movement.
Yeah, I was just going to say, the wind really picked up here about a second ago. This field is notorious for getting quite windy during games in the evenings.
Waltham.
And the penalty is against Waltham. So it looks like Winchester is going to keep it, and they're going to replay third down.
Another forced deep ball here, Nikhil.
I think they would. They would.
Going to bring up third down and 14.
Cancel
the
penalty, so that they would have fourth and they'd go for a kick. But Dombowski's hollering to the ref to call a timeout. Something's off. He's confused about something.
Timeout.
Having
Winchester.
A chat with the ref. And they'll come down here. There's a first timeout for Winchester being used already. 2:56 to go in the first quarter.
Considering there's about 3 minutes left in the first quarter, Nikhil, I think what Coach Dombowski is telling the team right now is they have 3 minutes. They have to stop this advance by Waltham. Sure, that third and 14, but that doesn't stop them getting a kick or a deep ball. This deep ball is a determining factor in who takes this point here. Also, Nikhil, what I'm also noticing from Winchester is their defensive backs and linebackers. They seem to be performing also extremely well. They're stuffing the receiver, which is stopping Waltham's quarterback from really making any moves. So both the linebackers and linebackers, quarterbacks, defensive backs, and the linemen are all playing to their standard. They're playing to the point, and it seems to be kind of like a iron will of sorts.
Yeah. It's now going off this, we haven't seen too much passing. We haven't seen too much one-on-one with the corners. Now, they're always lining up in man coverage. Waltham's not throwing. Winchester's not throwing. Both teams electing to be a bit more safe. Question is, do you go for a throw here?
I would go for a throw.
And it looks like Dombowski changed his decision somehow. So it's going to be fourth down and nine. So they'll go for the kick. On comes Ramirez again on the attempt. Edwin Ramirez, number 11 on the 26-yard attempt.
It's windy here, Nikhil, so it's very disappointing to stay here.
Hold
is
down, kick is up, and it is good. It was very low kick. He didn't get the contact he wanted, my guess, but lucky for him, it went through very low. That was close to being below the crossbar.
That was close, but also pretty clean. It just went, just whooshed through it. Even in windy conditions, if you're able to get a kick like this, that's pretty good.
Now, if you're Winchester here, that's the best scenario. You limited them to 3 points. Now you have plenty of time to go back the other way, score some points, get on top.
I'm excited to see Winchester here. We haven't gotten to see much of their offensive game. That's most of the time been at the Winchester goal line. And I feel like it's time to pull up the cards. It's time to pull up their receivers. Time to show what they've got and time to give it their all.
If you require assistance, please call upon Winchester.
Since the game started, crowds really started packing in more.
Wow, that's a lot of people here for the first and for the opening debut of Winchester at home. And that's a great thing. It's really nice to see all the fans so happy and loyal to see our team go.
Of course, we touched up on last week's game, which was away at Newton South. And in that game, Winchester won 13-6. They scored two touchdowns. One of them was a big 60-yard touchdown from Harry Lowenstein to Ben Wilson. We'll see if he throws another deep ball like that this week.
And I'll tell you, it's going to be exciting. Waltham knows their coverage. Waltham has his own coverage in date. Well, let's see here. The kick goes.
Another squib kick, this time to the outside, and it's out of bounds, and that should draw a flag. And, yep, the referee brings his flag out. Now, if you kick it out of bounds on a kickoff, the other team gets to start at their 40, which is a pretty good advantage for them. So Winchester will start here from their 40-yard line. They have 60 yards to go to score a touchdown.
I mean, Nikhil, we have seen all these 60-yarders, and there's only 2 minutes, 21 seconds left in the game.
That's actually the first quarter.
I know it's the first quarter, but even so, I counted the time limit. I'd say let's go for it, 2 minutes, 41 seconds. Let's see what we can do, see if we can beat the time limit, and let's do this. And I feel like we should.
It looks like they're going to redo the kickoff instead of starting at the 40. I must have had the rules confused. They're going to start the kickoff from further back, it appears. 5 yards back, I think.
Wilson and Goodrich set back deep for Winchester receive.
As the PA announcer just said, number 4, Ben Wilson, number 5, Emmett Goodrich, back for Winchester deep for the kickoff. But Waltham's already squibbed it twice. Let's see if they do it a third time.
Two of some of their best receivers. Two of the best receivers they've had on this team, and I'm excited to see what they can do here.
And it's another squib kick up the middle, and it's recovered by Doucette again, and he's taken down around the 45. Players start
hovering towards each other.
Overall,
Dombowski wanting a flag there for the hit on Doucette. It looks like the Waltham player caught Doucette's helmet, and it sort of twisted a little, which is kind of dangerous. It's like the refs didn't catch it.
An overall 5-yard gain ever since the penalty was being declared. That's going to be a good sign for Winchester. It's only going to put them about 55 yards from the goal line, and that's good. I feel like that might be a stop here. But here's the thing. I also feel like I'm going for another dink and dunk here. As it
looks like Goodrich is in the backfield this time instead of Doucette.
Looks like it's going to be a man coverage here with the safety in back.
The handoff is to Goodrich, and he's stuffed by Waltham. Brings him back to the 40, a loss of around 4 yards.
Goodrich on the clock carry still for runs, Winchester.
And Winchester brings up second down and long.
Goodrich is there. I believe the Goodrich is a starting running back here. So putting him out here is going to –
second down and 12
out,
for Winchester.
What I would do here is if I was in the mid of the field, then I'd put out Wilson on the far post side.
And it looks like he is lined up on the far left side, man on man, with Rashid Marshall.
Let's see if Rashid Marshall kicked down Wilson. Let's see here.
And it is going to be a pass to Wilson. The pass was a little in front of Wilson, though, and flag comes out afterwards.
Flag on
the
play.
In the backfield, 76 is there.
Personal foul, roughing the passer.
And it's going to be roughing the passer.
Waltham.
On Waltham, number 76, that's Scott Richardson. Now, that's a penalty you do not want to take. That's an automatic first down for Winchester. Or is it?
Is it? On the scoreboard, it says second down. That's a bit unusual.
No, but it's just not updated. It should be first down.
Yeah, you're right.
Refs moving the ball up to the 43-yard line. Winchester in good position now in Waltham's half. Just about 40 yards to go. Goodrich is going to stay in the backfield, and it looks like Coach Dombowski is going to alternate running backs between drives, having Doucet and Goodrich switch out with each other.
The wind's gusting here. It's very windy up top here. So
Emmett Goodrich being a sophomore from Winchester High. Wilson in motion, and it's going to be a quick toss to Wilson, but he's stopped in the backfield by Waltham, number 77, Isaiah Lusant, the senior at Waltham High. Makes
Wilson
a great
on the carry
defensive
for Winchester.
Stop, reading Winchester like a book.
Yeah, here's the thing, he's also a linebacker here, and it's great to see that the linebacker is able to get
down
through the line.
14
he's able to maneuver through.
Now with second down and 14, looks like Winchester's going to bring trips on the left side.
These plays are going extremely fast here.
Three wide receivers on the outside is trips, and they got Goodrich still in the backfield. Wilson solo on the right side.
Okay, it looks like it's going to be a run here for Goodrich.
Waltham showing blitz now, and he's going to back up a little. And it's going to be a fake. And no, it's going to be a run from Goodrich, and he goes to the outside.
Goodrich on the
makes
carry
around
for
7 yards. That'll bring up third down and mid, around third down and six. So there's 30 seconds to go here. There likely is only going to be one more play in this quarter before the second quarter.
Now there's some action here, Nikhil. I'm starting to pump up. The whole thing's going. I'm ready here.
It's up to the coach here whether he wants to run the play or not. They don't have to. The play clock is turned off, which means they can run a play or not.
Yeah,
Waltham looks a bit mixed up on defense. Let's see if Lowenstein snaps.
Waltham seems adamant on starting it, and looks like Winchester is doing it.
And they got it, but and there's man wide open. Akira was wide open down the middle, brings up the first down, and that wraps up the first quarter. When we come back to you in the second quarter, Winchester will start
at
the 25-yard line, just outside of the red zone. Going the other way, of course.
Yeah. End of the first quarter. Winchester. We'll be right back.
Welcome back after that short break. Brings up the start of the second quarter here at Moulton Field in Winchester, Massachusetts.
Here we go. Looks like to be Winchester is.
Goodrich is still in the backfield, number five. Lowenstein's going to hand off to Goodrich. Goodrich has a hole for a second, but it closed really fast, and he's going to be brought down at the 22-yard line.
Goodrich on the carry for Winchester.
Geo Askert Hill.
That's
going to
bring up second down
tackle
and
here.
Seven.
He is a defensive back and wide receiver for Waltham High. Brings up second down and seven.
Now, Nikhil, what I would do here if I was Winchester is second and seven, great time to pass, obviously. Go for dink and dunks here. Looks like they're bringing out the
kicking net. Kieran Kaur is going to warm up his leg. Now a fake handoff. Lowenstein is going to go to the outside. And he's all the way down to the 10-yard line.
For a first down for the Red Blacks.
Looks like Bronner Keogh took that pass.
Yeah, number 18, Bronner Keogh getting into the action. Haven't seen much of him so far tonight. And that's a big play to bring up first down and 10 just outside the 10-yard line.
And it seems like that's how Winchester is going to beat the Waltham's defense here. Yeah, is by simply just circulating around it, but in different directions, whether it be left or right, up or down, it's gonna put Waltham out of confusion. It's going to confuse them. But Waltham, you have seen Waltham stop it before. But what I would say to you also fool him with like Goodrich or whatever, like going around.
Looks like it's going to be a wildcat formation. Costello took the snap to the outside, but he stopped at the 6-yard line. Costello was in the backfield with Doucette. Costello has played
Jackson
quarterback
Cirelli
in the past.
The
of course,
Winchester.
He switched. That was Jack Santarelli, number 16. Costello's 6.
Jack Santarelli pulling off a wildcat play. That's a great, honestly amazing. Jackson really could.
Looks like they took out Lowenstein and they're just going to replace him with Costello at this point.
Jack Costello says in the roster he's a wide
receiver.
Second
down and goal for the Red
Blacks. It could be a back of a wildcat play, maybe, but.
This would be a Santarelli.
Jack
Santarelli, the other Jack.
Jack Santarelli being a quarterback for the Red and Black Junior.
Santarelli hands it off to Doucette. Doucette's going to be taken
down
around the 4-yard line. That brings up third down and short.
Here's the thing now. It all comes down to the
coaching.
Going to
bring up third and goal.
Doucette, you saw it in that play right there. Doucette has good feet. He knows the motions. He knows the maneuvers. And Jack Santarelli also has the tactics in check. He's able to get away from the running back and just book it.
Santarelli having a discussion with offensive coordinator Tom Carr and Harry Lowenstein. We'll see who gets the snap here on this pivotal third down with just under 10 minutes to go in the second quarter. Now, the coaching staff having some words with the referee. Let's see what it's going to be. Waltham's all ready to go. There's some confusion on the Winchester sideline. And looks like they're going to call a timeout.
Timeout, Winchester.
Timeout here will actually be actually pretty good because they only have one timeout now in this entire half. So
now they got to think over this play. If they don't make it, they got a reliable kicker in Kieran Kaur in the back to trust. Last week, Kieran Kaur kicked an extra point and had one blocked. Of course, that's not the kicker's fault.
Kieran is going to. I feel Kieran being back on this team is actually a great, because Kieran originally in the 2020 season, he played extremely well. He was the determining factor in several of their games.
And then last year, he took the year off of football to focus on soccer. So, of course, a lot of soccer players have great legs, which is why he's come to football to kick.
I feel like this kicking alternation would be very helpful for him in the long run. And that's going to be, awesome to see. Him pursuing a career in both soccer and kicking, that'll be interesting.
Now it looks like Lowenstein's going to take the snap this time. So after those two plays of Jack Santarelli that we saw, Lowenstein showing that he is the man, the quarterback, for your Winchester Red and Black.
It looks like Ben Wilson's going off the field, so it could be a...
Ben Wilson lined up on the right side. Schlesinger, Keogh, and Akira trips on the left. Lowenstein steps back. Doucette's open, and he's
touchdown,
into the end zone. That is a touchdown.
Lower speed pass is complete to Doucette.
Just a quick pass to the right outside. Doucette finds the end zone. He found the hole in the Waltham defense. And these short passing plays work so far. Works again, and on comes Cora for the extra point. Winchester up 6-3 now to make it 7.
Doucette's able to, like I said, Doucette's able to maneuver. He's able to diverge and tell, oh, Waltham's going for man coverage here. And it looks
Holder
like he has the
Killian O'Connor, number 32. Snaps up, and the kick is blocked again. It was a bad hold.
Extra point is no good.
And it'll stay 6-3 Winchester. Unfortunate for the red and black. O'Connor fumbled the snap.
Yeah, that's gonna put them at a 6-3. So even a field goal, Waltham is gonna stop that. But Winchester, we saw their defense. Their defense is adamant on stopping Waltham at the close line. So what I'm guessing is the ending score could be, and I'm guessing it could be 6-6 even, putting that even. So that's gonna be very pressurizing on the last half of the game.
Now on comes Core again to kick it off.
I feel like it's gonna be another squib here, and that's gonna end up. I feel that'll end up pretty.
Core is also known for his long kickoffs, kicks in 60 yarders.
Registry back last deep for Waltham.
We've also seen some squibs from Waltham. We'll see how Winchester responds. I feel like Kieran's known for his long kicks here, but he could also try a squib if he so desired for a bit more time, for a bit more action packed here. That would be cool. Looks like though, so Waltham's ready to receive a deep kick by Kieran, which is expected.
Connolly back deep. Connolly and Registry. Core lining up.
Kieran, of course, set the kick off for Winchester.
And Core's kick is booted up high, almost to the goal line, and it's picked up at the 1 yard line. Returning his Registry up the right side. He had a hole. He's still going. And he trucks a man down to the 40, and it takes 5 Winchester defenders to take him down. What a return by 7 Josh Registry on Waltham, setting them up with great field position.
Carry for Waltham
again.
That puts him at the 35. That's almost in field goal range already. That's gonna pressure Winchester here, and I feel like that's gonna poke the pressure point for the defense here. The Winchester is gonna be poised and ready now. I feel
the defense has been up to the task as of now. We'll see if they can hold strong once again. This Waltham attack, of course, led by Jack Renaud. It's been a little while since we've seen them after that long Winchester drive down the field that brought us the Doucette touchdown.
All right, here. Looks like it's going to be Winchester. It looks like they might be going man coverage here, but it's going to be a bit of a deeper man. It seems that it's also going to be a run by Waltham with two people on the back.
And it's a fake handoff. And he's going deep. And it's intercepted by Schlesinger, the safety. Returning it up the right side. He has open field being chased from behind. And he's taken down at the 35. And there's a flag on the play, which is likely going to be for unnecessary roughness.
Well, Schlesinger on the interception.
What a play
for Winchester.
By
Schlesinger. There's a flag
he
on the play.
He read the quarterback's eyes perfectly and undercut the receiver, which was Registry.
You can see the quarterback. He was in the stretch position here. And the quarterback, he tried taking care of it, and he was able to do so. And
flags.
He was like, okay, I'm focusing. Right field. Maybe I'll hold the left field. He goes left field, chucks it deep, and Schlesinger has the keen eye. He has the read, and he just snatches it.
So an unfortunate turn of events for Waltham.
Okay, looks like here it's going to take a bit of confusion here.
They're declining the penalty, I believe.
It's going to be a challenging the penalty here. Ooh, that's going to be interesting. Oh, decline, sorry. Decline the penalty here. That's going to bring, I believe, Winchester will be at around Waltham's 30, 35. And if that's the case, that's going to put them directly opposite positions. So about a play ago, maybe about a minute ago, we saw Waltham going for Winchester at the 35. Now we see exactly the opposite.
That's a big play by Schlesinger. Everything's just suddenly gone wrong all of a sudden for Waltham. It looks like the penalty was actually on Winchester, so they're going to back it up to around midfield where they will start off this possession.
Even in midfield, that still gives them a good playing field, literally speaking, to actually, you know, to actually capitalize off the opportunity they have on the passing game.
Now, last drive, we saw plenty of short passes from the red and black. Let's see if they continue that or if they up the tempo, go for some deeper shots. But it's only 6-3, so don't get too cocky. Don't try anything too fancy.
I mean, I'm a man of action, so I want to see as many defenses as humanly possible.
Who doesn't want to see that? But yeah, it's not practical. Of course, the goal of the game isn't to entertain the audience. I mean, it's to win the game.
Then again, we do see Ben Wilson on the sideline here. We do see him a lot. And that's the same place where he caught several line of touchdowns before. So let's see here.
Now it's a fake handoff. He's looking for the aforementioned Wilson in double coverage. Mullins, it's out of bounds, which might have been the best option there. Wilson was not open by any means, and if it was in bounds, there was a high chance it could have been intercepted.
Also, you can see what I found really interesting. You can see Lowenstein's ability to fake out. He's able to, looking at the left field, like, I'm going to throw a bit to the screen pass. And then he's just like, no, just kidding, I'm throwing to Wilson. And that's a great thing you see out of a ton of quarterbacks nowadays. And it's honestly going to be a hard thing to beat, and Waltham's going to have to adapt to the possibility. We have seen over the past game.
Now, as I said before, it looks like Winchester's switching running back between drives. Last drive was Goodrich. Now it's back to Doucette. Of course, Doucette had the touchdown on the last drive. Now here's Doucette again up the middle. And it only gets past one defender before he's dragged down by the 46-yard line. That's going to bring up third down and 5. So, of course, they're outside of field goal range. If they don't pick it up here, they're going to have to punt it.
The field goal, Kieran Core, considering he's been in soccer, considering he's kicked before and he has been a great asset to the team, I think the field goal range may be, let's say, underestimated for Kieran Core. But we'll see here. We'll see. I think Kieran Core can.
And Waltham jumped. So, 88 pointing his head to the sky, knowing it's his fault. It's Dylan West who jumped off sides, which will shorten the third down. That could bring up a first down, if I'm not mistaken. And they haven't moved the chains yet. Now they're going to start moving the chains, so that
That's
will be a first down.
First down for the red and black.
So, a costly mistake.
That's going to get. That would be
West.
That might give the Winchester red and black the opportunity they've been looking for here to maybe go for to keep up the game, keep up their score. They're pursuing, they're ambitious, and I'm all for it. Let's see it here.
Just under 8 minutes to go. Another handoff to Doucette. And Doucette is stuffed at the line of scrimmage. No hole opening up this time.
Ryan
Charge
Doucette
led by 76 Scott Richardson for Waltham, stuffing the Winchester running back.
It seems the captain
brings up second down.
It seems that the team captains in Nebeski are adamant on having the
run by
Goodrich, as you said. And Waltham and Waltham's line and their back line of linebackers is just they're not having it. They want to make sure.
Yep.
If they're isolating one thing from Winchester, it's gonna be their running back. It's gonna be
Goodrich. That is their main game. Winchester's mostly known for their run game. Dropping back is Lowenstein. Quick pass to the outside. There's Wilson cutting towards the middle, and he's brought down just about 2 yards short of the first down marker, bringing up third down and short. Now, if you're Winchester here, you have an option. You either pass or you
Joseph
run.
Joseph Johnson on the tackle.
But it looks like they're
going
to bring out some bigger players, indicating that they're going to go for a run, bringing out their receivers.
They're down and 3 for the red and black.
And here comes Centarelli again. So Lowenstein's being taken off for a quick breather, and Centarelli being put on. Now, we saw a lot of this last year. Last year, they had many rotating quarterbacks between Centarelli, Lowenstein, and, of course, Derek Jancy.
It's really almost interesting to see the line just packed. It's going to be a blitz here by the looks of it.
Run by Centarelli up the middle. There's a hole, and he picks up the first down. Brought down at the 29-yard line. Refreshing the set of downs with just
down.
Under 6.5 to go.
We're halfway through the quarter already, and I thought it was up in about 2 minutes. But yeah, we see Lewis first down on around their 28-29 yard line here. That puts them in field goal range. That puts them in passing range for a touchdown. That puts them in an opportunity to go for a screen pass and maybe not risk losing as much. But this looks to be a run here. But he's set.
Hand off to Doucette up the middle, and he gets a couple of yards fighting for it. Gets
Ryan
about 5, and that should bring up around second down and 5. Getting ever so closer to the red zone, which is, of course, the zone within 20 yards.
Winchester's game plan here seems to be a bunch of very short yard progressions.
Waltham.
Waltham's expecting, like I thought.
Second down and four
They're expecting a deep ball here. They're expecting, Chuck to Wilson. We'll give him double coverage.
But, of course, Waltham's also made a lot of mistakes on their own end, which has been costly, just like a couple of those penalties and that costly interception from Renaud. Doucette now in motion in the backfield. Lowenstein not looking at him. And it's a ball to Wilson. Wilson wasn't looking, so a bit of a miscommunication. And that brings up third down and four. Wilson was one-on-one, so it was a good chance. Looking for a fade route to the outside. But, of course, there was that slight miscommunication between receiver and quarterback, which we see so often.
So Ben Wilson ran to Landon Foster, who is, I believe, is he a
third down and four for the red and black.
But Landon, I think that Wilson accidentally ran into Landon Foster, which is what cost him the touchdown. So
let's see. It should be an interesting play call. Just above 5 minutes, 20 seconds to go. They got third down. It's a, like, you need to do something here. Effective. Waltham backs up a bit, and it's a run to Doucette, but he's stopped.
Doucette on the carry.
Around the 34-yard line. Let's see. Is this within Cora's range, or are they going to punt it?
Looks like it's going to be a field goal
Joey
here.
Joey Agostino for the tackle for Waltham.
Yeah, they're
going
to
That's going to bring up
the last play was taught by Dylan Boyle, I think it was.
Now yes. Number 16, they got a different holder this time. It's Jack Santarelli to hold from the middle or towards the right hash. It's about a 42-yard attempt for Kaur.
Kieran Kaur, I feel like he got it. The wind's pulled. It's ready.
Snap down. Holds good. The kick is blocked again by Waltham. And the refs haven't blown the whistle. The play's still alive. And down at the 40.
Field goal was blocked.
Patty Galfin recovering it, preventing any further
Waltham will take over on
That's
the
40-yard
line.
That's two blocked kicks this game for Winchester. So their line having some trouble on the kicks. They gotta pick it up and block for the kicker, Kaur.
Yeah, Winchester seems to be trying to lay it down. They seem to be focusing on the defense. They seem to be laying down their foundation.
But they're losing focus on special teams.
Yeah,
and you can never underestimate the importance of special teams.
You're right, you can't. So, but in losing focus on special teams and losing priority of the offense, you have to get the opportunity to build foundation of defense. I think what they're doing here. Looks like it's going to be a.
Let's see if Renaud can redeem himself for the pick he just threw a couple of minutes
coverage.
Ago. They're going to have a running play this time. The Connolly, who sheds a man, but is only going to make it a couple of yards. He shedded past number 16, Santarelli.
The issue
right, Connolly on the carry for Waltham.
The issue with Waltham is not in its player. Someone wants
good for a five-yard gain. That's bringing up second down and five.
You seem to have three out of the four receivers or four out of the five receivers. They seem to always go in a straight parallel line. And one of the receivers always seems to go for a slant or a curve. And that seems one of the always structures. So that's how Winchester is able to recognize and go for it.
Now Waltham's got a new back. A quick pass to the outside. And there's number seven with Registry again. And he's going
to
pick up the first down for Waltham now into Winchester's side of the field.
And that is good for a Hawks first down.
Approaching 3 minutes and 50 seconds on the clock.
Well, just like that, they're able to adapt to their mistakes.
Waltham having no backs in the backfield. They got four lined up in trips on the right side. A quick snap. Everyone's confused, and it's a pass to Connolly. He's going to cut past one, and
flag
as he gets down to the 42-yard line. Everyone was confused in the play. Winchester not ready for the play. Waltham trying to take advantage of it. They got a couple of yards. Good play, but we'll see who the penalty's on.
The penalty might be on Winchester?
It's going to be a holding penalty on Waltham. Another costly penalty. It's already their fourth or fifth big costly penalty that's pushing them back. So they're going to have to stop committing these penalties or
they might lose the game because
10-yard penalty. That will be
first down and 20. The penalties stopped them from getting a touchdown there in the previous drive.
And if you're Winchester, just be happy that your discipline so far has been pretty good compared to Waltham's.
Waltham seems to be doing great, but they seem to be a bit sloppy on the penalties. Winchester's been playing it very carefully and laying on their foundation.
Now it's going to be a run on the right side. There's Connolly. He has a burst of speed through some open space.
Ty Connolly brings it down near
the first down marker. It should bring up second down in about one, maybe even inches. So any impact that penalty had, it's already
gone.
Good
for a Waltham first down.
Right side, offensive line creating a big gap for Connolly to burst through.
Wow, that's a one hell of a run. Not a bat, they're almost in field goal range at this rate.
If I'm Winchester, I might even want to call a timeout here. They're looking a bit disoriented.
Charlie on the carry.
Great stop.
Dabowski's staying in motion.
In the backfield.
If I was Dabowski, I would go straight for a timeout like Nikhil said. But
they need to reorganize a little.
Seems that they're
Hogan Salvetti on the tackle for Winchester.
It seems that Winchester's also going for his own coverage here, but that seems a bit unusual. It's doing all their runs of it in Connolly, and Dabowski's trying to signal something here.
He's trying to keep them on the field. They got some more confusion. Now it looks like they're all settled and ready for the play. Drops back. Another quick pass to the left side. This time there's Gaspar, and he makes it to the 29-yard line. That's
Owen Gaspar,
the wide receiver for Waltham High, senior.
The more I'm starting to look at, the more I'm starting to realize these offenses are pretty similar to each other.
Third down and three for the Hawks.
One of them is more pass-oriented, while the other one's much more run-oriented. Because you see Waltham is always going for that Connolly. They always want Connolly. They always say, oh, Connolly, are you open? All right, you're taking the ball. Let's go.
Head coach for Waltham calling the plays is Sean Brackett. You can see him on the sideline. Looking tense here on the third and three. He wanted a quick pass and a blitz up the middle and a sack for 54. There's Brogan Salvietti. What a play by Salvietti.
Brogan Salvietti on the sack for Winchester.
The offensive line get the sack. Brings up fourth down and long. And Waltham, you think, would punt it here with less than two to go.
And honestly, Brogan Salvietti, he was able to do, he has good hands. He's able to stop. He's able to stop the lineman. He's able to get past the lineman. He's able to juke him through, and he's able to just squirm through.
Looks like the offense is staying on the field here. They're going to go for it on 4th and 14. They're
going to
probably try to run
the
clock out.
That's a very unusual play.
This is a bit risky since they're near midfield.
For some reason, they have the running back in the backfield.
And they're trying to draw him off sides. That's what it was. He's using the hard count.
Waltham's
going to call a timeout. They're just running the clock out, trying to jump him. And now the special teams unit will come on, and Ramirez will go on for the punt. Now, with just above a minute to go, Winchester is going to have a big field to go, so they'll likely take some deep shots, if not just try to close out the half on a good note.
So it seems to Nikhil that they have two options here. They can go for a very far punt here, or a very far kick for a field goal, or then go for just a simple squib kick. Or
I don't think in high school anyone's kicking from that far.
Yeah, but it'd be really ambitious. I've seen Kieran Cord do that, but that would be, I've seen Kieran Cord do that several times. But it'd be, honestly, it's a possibility. It's physically possible, but it's very difficult.
So it looks like the quarterback's coming back onto the field. There's Jack Renaud again, so we're mistaken. They're not going to go for the punt. They're going to take a deep shot here. They need 13 yards for the first down.
That's really
They already
ambitious.
Tried the hard count tactic. So we'll see what ambitious play the coach has drawn up here.
Play right here.
Four players on the outside.
I mean, here we finally going to see a Hail Mary here. I haven't seen one in a long while.
He drops back. He's looking. Coverage is good. But there's a man wide open, and he drops it.
Registry
drops it.
Registry is incomplete. Winchester will take over on downs.
An unlucky play for Waltham. Winchester's going to take over on downs from just around midfield. Now, this could prove to be costly for Waltham. Winchester has a short field to work with, and a minute is plenty of time, if you ask me, although they only have one timeout.
Here you go. So, yeah, we only have a minute. Actually, I only have a minute left until the half's over. And that's going to be I'd say, including timeout, it gives them at least 2 minutes, a minute and a half. To capitalize off this opportunity they're given one time to do it, and Wilson to the back. Looks like it's going to be Doucette and Wilson are both on the field. Some of their two best players.
Lowenstein back now. Four receivers on the outside. There's a blitz up the middle. It's behind Doucette.
Lowenstein
caught it with one arm. Couldn't
complete.
Do much there.
That's
as there was a blitz up the middle,
the
not picked up by the offensive line. 53 seconds to go now. Second down and 10. They're going to take deep shots, which we haven't seen much. Let's see if Lowenstein finally lets loose one long ball. Now they're going to line up in trips on the right side, three wide receivers.
Second and 10. I feel like this would be a good time to go for a slant up the middle, because we haven't seen many passes.
Remember,
the
they don't have time, though. The
yeah,
clock's going to run
exactly.
If they don't go out of bounds.
Yeah,
it looks like someone is going to be subbed
off. It may
off
be timely, but passes are practically their only way to get through, because that stops the clock. That takes off time, and they can use that. They can use that slam up the middle to, you know, maybe get into field goal range or something along those lines to at least have the opportunity to score some kind of points in the last minute of the half.
And it's going to be a fake hand, or no, it's going to be a normal handoff to Doucette. He's not going to get much yardage. And it looks like they're going to just look to try to close the half out with a run. But
timeout, Waltham.
Waltham calls a timeout to stop the clock.
It's going
to
bring up third down and 10.
Looks like Winchester's just trying to close out the half, but Waltham's having none of it, calling a timeout. And they want the ball back. They want to take a deep shot if Winchester doesn't convert here.
What I would do here if I was Winchester is their second timeout on Waltham for the half. I'm guessing that if whatever happens in this play right here could determine the game. It could be a large factor. Because what I would do here for Winchester is I go for a deep ball here. Because one, you have, it's less risk and more reward. Two, it also puts them in field goal range. Three, it puts them in first down to even go for maybe a touchdown. Four, it also puts Waltham at a disadvantageous state in case they get the ball.
Waltham's coaches are on the field right now having a word with the refs. They're not happy about something. Don't know what that something is.
Looks like Waltham's going for a zone defense. They're anticipating the deep pass. Looks like it.
They're moving the ball up. So let's see what happened.
I'm not sure.
That's penalty against Waltham. That's good for a red block first down.
There was a penalty on the bench. Oh my goodness! Another costly penalty for Waltham. That brings a first down and 10. I didn't see a bench penalty, but there must have been something.
I guess they already have the advantage
from
state.
Waltham's side of the field. They great field position once again.
They're in great field position. They may not have the field goal they're desiring. They're looking for.
It's a quick pass to the outside, and it's pushed wide.
Is it
Keo.
Complete?
So Keo's third target of the night. He, of course, had that one great play inside the red zone earlier on Winchester's touchdown drive.
Yeah, second down and 10 for the red and black.
To see that Lowenstein's passing game for screen passes. It seems that Waltham's starting to slowly adapt. Well, there might be some
timeout, Winchester.
Winchester's going to call a timeout with 37 seconds to go, try to draw something up. Now, if you're Winchester, what do you think the target goal line is to get into kicking range?
I feel like the target goal line, for in terms of Kieran Cora as a kicker on your team, one of the best kickers, in my opinion, one of the best kickers I've seen in a while, is I'd say the kicking range is about in the 33-yard line.
So around the 45-yard field goal.
Yeah, around 45-yard field goal. Maybe a bit ambitious, but hey, I'm an ambitious guy. I'm looking for that.
Of course, they're going to have to actually get the kick up this time. Both kick attempts today been blocked, so Waltham's special teams unit has been on fire.
Waltham seemed to have everything on point. They seem to know what they're doing. But here's the thing. They're both adamant forces, like two forces clashing together here.
Hey, just a second ago when we had the bench penalty, I'm going to assume that the bench penalty was actually on the coach for running out on the field and yelling at the refs about something. Looks like he's mad at the refs, and the refs are having none of it, not taking the nonsense.
Wow, look at this. Both the refs.
Lowenstein drops back, pump fake, and he goes deep in a double coverage, and it's caught and dropped. Wilson had it, but at the last second, it slips out of his hands, and that's going to bring up third down and 10 from around midfield.
Lowenstein sees that pocket collapse. He has no other thing. He sees.
Third down and 10 for the red and black.
He just goes for it. He's like, all right, I'm chucking it deep. Chucks it deep. Ben Wilson, maybe a triple coverage, but he almost had it. He had it in his hands.
I want to see him target someone else this time.
Yeah, I do want to see him. They do have the opportunity to mix their options up. Looks like there's another run here.
And they're going to run it to Doucette. And this time, they're probably going to go
Doucette on a carry for Winchester.
And Waltham's going to run up and call a timeout, not letting him do that. So with 20 seconds to go.
Timeout, Waltham.
Winchester's gonna punt.
This is their last timeouts. Now we have no more timeouts. 20 seconds left in the game.
They have no timeouts, and they're gonna have to go a ridiculously long distance. They're gonna have
Fourth
to go around like 90 yards.
This is intense. Fourth and ten on the Winchester. Fourth and ten for Winchester. Timeout call on Waltham. What would you do here, Nikhil?
If I'm Winchester, just try to get as best of a punt as possible. And if Waltham does try anything, just play deep zone coverage. You can give them yards. Bend, but don't break, as they say. You don't want to let them score a touchdown.
Yeah, I'd say that's the big goal, don't want to score a touchdown. But then again, you know, I'm an ambitious guy. I might fake it. I might go for it. I want to see how Waltham adapts to some of those things, like faking it and just, Kuhn in the pocket, chucks deep, and then it's caught by Wilson. That'd be really interesting. I'd love to see that. But probably won't happen. Probably be one of the most logical thing to do. But I mean, I'd assume it's a punt here.
Right? Outcomes for the punt. Back deep is, again, the receivers for Waltham.
Josh Registry back deep for Waltham.
Registry had that big return earlier. Around 60 yards, they should put him in good range. And the snap is over Core's head. And he's going to have to think of something quick, and he's just going to fall on it. So a disastrous play for the red and black that's going to set up Waltham
at the 25-yard line.
And even worse, Kieran's limping. This could be a huge momentum shift in the game. If Waltham can get a big play and can even possibly score a touchdown.
What a surprise. Yeah, Waltham's special teams are on point. Wow, they know when, like, they're able to jump. They have the capability.
Winchester special teams has been struggling tonight. They're going to have to pick that up.
That could explain why we have the net here, because we could have some of the kickers trying an opportunity to kick it. Don't get wrong, kick.
Of course, we saw the Waltham extra point, or the short field goal a little while ago. Made it.
Looks like it's going to be a
zone
defense.
Going to drop back. Looking deep. Now he's running out of the pocket, and he's being chased, and he's going to throw it out of bounds. Stop the clock with 6 seconds to go. And this is last-ditch opportunity. You either go for the end zone or you elect to kick, but it looks like the offense is going to stay on the field, and this is going to be a deep shot to the end zone. If you're Winchester, play deep zone. Don't let them score. If they score, that's going to be bad for you.
The key to Winchester is Winchester's pressure here. They're very pressured. It is the determining factor of the half. What happens here?
They just drop back. They don't rush many. They rush three. You play everyone in coverage. Prevent the touchdown as much as you can. Do anything you can to prevent the touchdown.
Yeah, everyone knows.
And as you can see, they are rushing three.
Everyone knows what's going on here. It all depends on the linebackers.
Now they're going to go. They were looking for a quick pass, and it's going to be to 21, and he's just going to go down near the line of scrimmage. That brings up the end of the first half at the Knowlton Turf between your Winchester Red and Black and the Waltham Hawks. And we'll catch you in just about 15 minutes for the start of the second half as the team marches off the field. My name is Nikhil Karthikeyan. Alongside me, Jason Turner.
Thank you. 6-3 Winchester, start of the third quarter. Have a good one.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Knowlton Turf here in Winchester for this home opener for your Winchester Red and Black against the Waltham Hawks. Right now, we're just about to begin the second half of play. Winchester entering the second half with a lead of 6-3. With an eventful end to the first half, let's see if they pick it up where they left off here in the second. Kaur's kick into the end zone. That'll be a touchback.
Great kick by Kaur there.
Touchback.
So now that we're in the second half, it's practically a new game. It's with Waltham being back by three. I mean, all it takes is a field goal to actually, you know, get them back in state. Number two, they're in their 15-yard. So they have to go. So that means they will have to go for a. Well, not have to, but I would like to see
Waltham will take over on their 20-yard line
for a deep pass here. But doesn't seem like that'll be the case. It looks like it's going to be a. Looks like to be a man coverage here. Yeah, man coverage.
Of course, the quarterback for Waltham High, number one, Jack Renaud. Quick handoff to Connolly up the middle, and he's just around the first down marker. Nearing a first down, brings up second down and short.
Connolly on the carry for Waltham.
Connolly been the featured back so far tonight for Waltham. They've switched him around, but of course he's the main.
Now, I'm starting to notice this now that we have a Waltham. Waltham has pulled out Waltham
second down and one for the Hawks.
All their cards, unless they have other options, they do. But they seem to pull out other big cards. Like, Winchester seems to have, Ben Wilson, Ryan Doucette.
Drops back, quick throw to the outside, and it's picked up by Registry. And takes three men to tackle him, but he's finally taken down.
Renault's pass is complete to Registry.
So that brings up the first down. The Hawks get started on another set of downs around their own 35-yard line, excuse me.
Yeah, speaking of Waltham, Waltham seems to have their own weapons. So they have Renaud, they have Connolly, and they have Register.
Now here's another run to Connolly, breaks through, gets about 8 yards.
Connolly on the carry for Waltham.
Speaking of Connolly.
And that should bring up just about the first down for the Waltham Hawks.
Now, a thing that should go undermentioned here is the line. The line so far for Connolly is pulling wonders. They're giving him 8 yard gains, not 10, 5 yard gains, when initially he was only getting 3 yard gains, 4 yard gains from the original play.
And just as we say that, the line gets stuffed by Winchester's own defensive line, and they're going to lose some yardage here. Great defensive stop by your Winchester Red and Black.
Speaking of line, yeah, exactly. The linemen on both sides. It takes
Park and Magnetel on the tackle for Winchester
to make their break the game.
And second down and 13 for the Hawks.
Renaud steps back, fires a pass to the outside.
Renaud's pass is complete.
And that's going to be about 5 yards gain. Brings up third down and long.
Third and long here is, honestly, you have no other option. You literally have no better option. But what I'm guessing that Waltham's going to do is Waltham's going to go for a screen pass around the
eight-yard pickup, third down and five.
And then they're trying to have
steps back. He's looking for a quick throw. It's intercepted again by Winchester. Up the right side goes Keogh. Teammates swarm him as they should. That's their second interception of the night. Renaud's second pick and another costly mistake from Waltham, resulting in a beneficial play for Winchester.
So Easton Housley, I believe, got the interception. Wow. Jeez, what a hell of an interception. That's a great, oh my gosh.
Teddy Galvin on the interception for Winchester.
Lots of linebacker in front of the receiver. And that's exactly
all
what happened
from his mother.
You saw the quarterback. The quarterback was in the pocket. He was aiming for the correct receiver. Chucks it, and then you saw Hazel Halsey just on there. He's right in front of it and just snatches it and then books it. Now that I just had to pay the state because of that.
Lowenstein drops back, going for a deep pass, and it's caught on a toe tapper. What a catch on the sideline. Oh, and the refs are going to say that it's incomplete. That's unlucky. They say it's out of bounds now.
Well, that was one hell of a catch.
It was one hell of an attempt, that's for sure.
The Bowski definitely gave us some motivating words. Wow. And also, the team seems playing one. The Bowski seemed to get the team's favor, which is a great thing. And the team learned. The team's doing amazing. They did great before, but now they're doing amazing.
Hell of a catch by Costello. Unfortunately, he was out of bounds.
Second down and 10 now being brought up. It's going to be a run to Doucette, who gets stuffed by the line. That's going to bring down third down and long. Now, if we had replays, I'd be really interested to go back and see the catch.
From what
I saw, he got two hands on the ball. He had control, and it looked like he got 2 feet in bounds, too. Patty Galvin.
Yeah, Nikhil, team that this game would make really some really good replays, really good recaps of both teams on their defense and offense, because it seems to be a much more running game.
Carr looks like he's switching up the play with Lowenstein. Wilson now shifting to the outside on the right. Fake handoff, and he's going deep for Akira, and he almost got a hand on it, just slightly overthrown. Brings up fourth down, and once again, Winchester does nothing with a turnover, and they're going to punt. Now, last punt, we saw a bad snap from the long snapper, resulting in a huge loss. We'd like to see some better long snaps. And now Doucette, when he's coming off the field, he's limping slightly. So we'll see what happens to that situation. Registry back. And it looks like they're kicking a 51-yard field goal. I was mistaken. I thought they were punting.
Wow, that's ambitious.
Let's see. Snap is high. Kick is up. And it's up. Let's see. And it's just slightly wide to the left. It had the distance, but slightly wide left. And Waltham will start from their own 40-yard line.
I mean, that was really close. He was right there. It takes a little more practice to actually, you know.
I thought it was in, personally.
Yeah, it looked in to me from this angle.
But then it slightly veered to the left the last second.
Yeah. Well, Waltham's been receiving the ball, and it looks like they're already prepped again. The offense and getting Connolly. It's going to be a very dink-and-dunk drive here.
Now, there's a bit of confusion at the line between the referees. Don't know what it is. There's someone's yelling plus 10.
I believe it's going for a penalty, but I don't think I saw a penalty on the field here.
Probably going to be talking right now about field position.
Looks like Dembowski's calling for the Walton to be pulled back. Looks like he's going for a penalty here. Dembowski's confused.
Looks like they're going to blow the play dead. They're saying something on the refs.
Timeout call from the referee.
The referees called a timeout. Looks like there's some error that happened.
So Dembowski's not so happy with the referee here. So I feel like Winchester's kind of at a standstill at this point. It's probably gonna be something very similar unless Winchester has a. Yeah, I feel like Winchester's gonna be on the. It's gonna be on the defensive end, and I feel like Walker's gonna pressure through. Winchester is zone coverage, so that's going to be interesting to see.
Looks like Waltham's got a long yard to work with. Long field to work with.
Yeah, I feel like
they're being sent back. So let's see what this is about.
Yeah, Looks like Waltham and Winchester are pretty confused, but one's in clustered and one's in scattered position. So,
unfortunately, we get no official explanation here. And so the PA announcer just cleared it up for us. As it turns out, in the MIAA's rules of football for high school football. A missed field goal results in the other team starting at the 20-yard line, which is where Renaud and Waltham starts. Now Connolly to the outside, who breaks a tackle, and he's down just before the first down marker at the 30-yard line.
On the carry for Waltham.
Wow, Connolly's on point today. Connolly's doing amazing. Like, he knows what he's doing. He's the running back of the Waltham Hawks, and he's showing it. He's definitely showing it. You see him know the positions. You've seen him know where he's going. He's like, okay, he evaluates what's going on here, and he said, oh, maybe he should change the play
back, and now it's up to Connolly. Another hole on the right side. Offensive line doing him good right now, giving him hole after hole. And he's getting another first down.
And
Waltham's really switched up after those two picks from Renaud. They've just changed to only ground game. They're just relying on the reliable running back. Quarterback's not having a great day. It's what you do when your quarterback's not having a great day.
I mean, here's the thing. The quarter, yeah, it looks like it's good.
Now here's another run, but Connolly's going to get stopped before Connolly even making it past the line of scrimmage. Great defensive play by Patty Galvin, number 19.
And here's the thing. Now that Waltham
Patty
is
Galvin on the tackle for
now
Winchester.
That Waltham is much more focused on Connolly and the running game, that's the opportunity Windsor gets to go for more man coverage and blitzing. That's the opportunity for Winchester to go, oh, hey, they're running for Connolly. Let's put an extra, three men on Connolly. Let's just book it for Connolly. Why not?
Connolly in the backfield. They're looking for a pass to the left side, and it's caught for the first down by Foy.
Noah Foy.
His first reception of the night, the sophomore at Waltham High School, bringing the Hawks to around the 50-yard line. Looks like they're trying to pick up the tempo, trying to go again. Here's another handoff, but he's not going to make it anywhere. Stuffed by the Winchester Red and Black defensive line at the line of scrimmage. Defensive line for Winchester picking it up now.
It's
two good stops in the last couple of plays for the line.
Now what I see Winchester doing here, because now that Winchester's, you see Waltham advancing the line, number one. Number two, it's really showing Winchester that Winchester has to improve on the
Renaud drops back looking for a short pass, and he hits it. And he's still going, and he's finally dragged down. It takes the entire team to take him down. That was Landon Foster, once again, number 17. And it looks like Winchester is going to call a timeout after that play. They looked a bit confused.
I think Winchester is primarily concerned with how they're going to adapt to the
drive
down. Because now that they're on their 45, then they have to make sure that, oh, hey, we I'm pretty sure their big goal is to prevent them from going in field goal range. They already got a field goal from the first drive they got here. So making sure to defuse that field goal is going to be a top priority. So what I say we should focus on the man coverage, not the zone coverage, the man coverage. Because what Connolly and Rashad are going to do is they're going to make sure that, oh, hey, we're going screen passes. Oh, hey, maybe we're going for a run. And those man coverage, along with maybe putting the safety a bit more closer to the gut, that is going to stop Waltham from making all those runs, making all those screen passes, because you already have the safety. You have the safety going in. You have the linebackers closing in too, and you also have all the corners making sure that, you know.
Winchester showing blitz here, and they are going to bring the heat. He's going deep ball on the left side, and he overthrows the receiver. But now there's a flag on the play. Could be pass interference on Winchester. That would be a big, costly mistake. Back there was registry being covered by 12 for Winchester, William Gans. I haven't seen much of him tonight.
It's good to see. Good to see these other players be able to show themselves in the defense. The defense, I think, is the prime place to show yourself, to show your opportunity.
Pass interference against Winchester.
And it was pass interference against Winchester, so Waltham will have a few free yards up the field. down to the Winchester 23 yards.
Hawks first down.
This seems to be a very penalty-based game. So it questions. So
a few shouts from the crowd of overthrow. Crowd not happy with it, at least a couple of parents. There's always those parents that get angry over everything. Winchester showing blitz again, and they're just going to run it up the middle, and they're not going to go anywhere. Got a couple of yards. Looks like the blitz has been successful. Last couple of plays, we've seen three or four blitzes. They've worked. Why not stick to the blitz? But if they're going to go for a pass, it's questionable. Blitz can be risky.
Blitz is very risky because you can just
say they're going for a pass.
Because the big counter to blitz is what they're good at, screen passes. So it surprises me that they're not going for that just yet. Maybe we'll sit here.
Now they're going to pass. Looking to his right. Now he's going to his left to Connolly. And Connolly's hit hard and low. Great defensive stop there from Patty Galvin once again. Patty Galvin's been all over the defense this game.
Patty Galvin, he's been going for it. He's been countering. You saw that. He knew it was a pass to Connolly, and he just slid. He just ran there and just slid, scurried him off the field.
And now looks like it's going to be a big third down here. Third down and 13. So if they don't convert, they're likely going to go for a field goal. Last time they were in this situation on a fourth down, they actually went for it.
It has to be defense.
No men in the backfield. He's looking to his right side, and he has a man, and it's draw. So that'll bring up fourth down and 13. Man who dropped it was Edwin Ramirez. Owen Gasper, sorry.
Here's the thing to kill. We did see a risky kick from Kieran Kaur. Do you think?
It looks like they're going to go for it. The special teams isn't coming out. The offense is staying out there. This is risky.
Wow.
There's still four minutes, 50 seconds in the third quarter. Yep. They have plenty of time. This is a big risk going for it here. This is something you do towards the end of the game when you don't have much time left, but they're deciding to do it now. They're only down by three. So I don't think this is a good play call from the coach. He's looking to the right side, or now he's looking to the left, and there's a screen pass. There's space that's wide open, and he gets the first down. There was a huge gap in Winchester's defense on the left side. And now Winchester player's down, and we're going to have a quick injury break.
To Ty Conley.
They had four blockers in front of Connolly. Winchester dropped back, expecting a deep pass, not a screen. And they just allowed him to get a first down. Now the players are going to go down on one knee for an injured teammate. Can't see who the injured teammate is from here.
Here's the thing. There's 4 minutes in.
And looks like it's Doucette again. Doucette was limping earlier. Now he's limping again, so he's going to come off. Winchester's number one featured running back.
Losing Doucette is going to be big loss for Winchester.
Yep, their offense is heavily reliant on Doucette.
Heavily reliant. That means that's probably going to force them to open up to the pass game more. They're going to have to go for more.
No, you know, that means that Goodrich is going to come in on offense as well.
You could also see a bit more Goodrich. That's a great thing to see. I'm glad that Doucette was building off the field. Very glad.
Anyway, now that brings up first down and 10 after the converted fourth down. There's a one-on-one on the right side, which I'm interested to see. No, they're just going to go for a running play. And he has a hole on the left side, and he's into the end zone. That is a touchdown, Waltham Hawks.
Touchdown, Waltham.
Adam Chisari, first time we've seen him tonight making a big play. Takes the hole on the left side into the end zone, and Waltham goes up 9-6 with 4:17 left in the third quarter.
And it's these players that always try to, that always are like with the ball, and they
Adam,
it's almost like a hit nonsense.
The
like they're able to,
for
juke you and fake you into thinking that something's going, and they're able to weave through the defense like it's a needle and thread.
Out
really
comes
amazing.
Edwin Ramirez once again, the kicker for Waltham. He is one for one on the night, having made a field goal earlier. See if he converts the extra point here. Snap is up, kick is good. And it's through the uprights that puts Waltham up 10-6.
This game's getting competitive now. So now that Waltham, is 4 points ahead, that means it practically forces Winchester to go for a touchdown or two field goals, but morally a touchdown.
Now, if you're Winchester, you're going to have to redraw some of your plans here. Your best running back's just gone down with an injury. He could return later. We don't know.
Looks like he's on the field. I don't think he's coming back.
He's just trying to stretch some stuff. Could be a cramp, potentially. And now coach is discussing their offensive plan here. Offense coordinator Tom Carr having a discussion with his team.
Now, if you were Waltham here, Nikhil, what would you do? Because now that you have your 10 points ahead, your
goals. Just don't give up any big plays or bad penalties like they've been doing all game. Not too many big plays given up, but there have been plenty of bad penalties. They need to be disciplined. They can't ignore this. Discipline has been a major problem for Waltham. Not just their players. The coach had a penalty on him earlier in the game. So the coach has got to calm down a little.
Yeah, their penalties are definitely costing them the game. They're able to get, I'm pretty sure they've gotten at least a.
Also, we can't forget the turnovers as well. There was those two interceptions.
Yeah, you're right.
Kicks on the left side. It might bounce out. No, it's going to stop right there. It's picked up by Winchester. They're going up the right side, tripped up around the 35.
Goodman
on the return.
Return for Winchester.
Now, here's the thing with Walton. I'm pretty sure they've given up at least a total of 20, 25 yards in terms of penalties. If they're able to cut down on the penalties in this last,
in this last
16 minutes
of
the game, then they have the opportunity to win and win hard.
Back comes Lowenstein leading the Winchester red and black offense, being the quarterback.
Now here's the thing. Lowenstein has all these deep threats that he hasn't used yet, and I'm wondering if this is the time to pull out the cards.
Let's see. So we got one of them, Ben Wilson, lined up in one-on-one man coverage on the outside. He's one-on-one against Rashid Marshall again. And the run to Goodrich is stuffed in the backfield. Waltham's defensive line imposing their will on him. That was number 77.
Goodrich on the carry.
Isaiah Lussant. Him and Richardson been tearing up the defensive line this game.
I've seen Lussant throughout the game so far. He's been able to, he's done his job, and he's done his job well. He's done his craft. He has the hands. He has the stop. He's able to stop the offensive and defensive linemen from making their move. And just now, we just saw a prime example of what a lineman should do and how he's supposed to do it.
Lowenstein switching up the play with Goodrich. His back, number 5. Fake handoff. He steps back and he's looking deep. And he has a man open and it's thrown behind. Looking for Bronner Keogh, number 18. And the pass was just a little behind. If he hit it, he would have had the first down. The defender who was covering him slipped and collided with Keogh after the throw.
Here's the thing when you're dealing
with
passing in the center, because you're probably going to have two people at least double coverage around
the
receiver. So
this brings up a long third down and 15. They're going to have to take either a deep shot or just try to give punters some room. You'd think they'd actually try and go for it.
I would go for it here.
Lowenstein drops back, looking for a quick pass to the right side, and he misses the receiver. Looking for Bronner Keogh again. And that'll bring up fourth down. On comes the punting unit. And number 9, Kieran Kaur, to punt it off. So the last punt from Winchester went horribly wrong.
Yeah, you every so often you get every so often you get drives that may result in stumps. But regardless of what happens, you keep up and persevere.
Snap is high again, but Cora's kick was shanked a little, and it falls down to the 40, and it's picked up by Connolly to the 45. So in the backfield, I actually noticed that after Cora kicked it, he was getting, there was a Waltham player in his face shoving him around a little. He wanted something from the refs. Refs aren't going to give him anything. That was, it's not something you see, someone interacting with the punter too often. Now on comes Renaud from the Winchester 45 to lead the Waltham offense in the charge.
So we've only seen Winchester give up 10 points so far in terms of defense, nine excluding the extra point. So if I was Winchester here, I would keep up the ambition. I'd keep up the focus on stopping Waltham from making any big
plays. Now it's a handoff to the right side. There's Connolly, and he's brought down after a couple of yards, but there's a flag on the play.
The ref
is right there, so he had a great view of what happened. Let's see what the call is.
Connolly on that last carry for Waltham.
He's going to call a holding penalty on the offense, so another costly penalty for Waltham. And that'll send them back for a first down and 20. Yet another penalty from this Waltham team. They lose today because of their costly penalties. You already know at their next practice they're going to be running laps and laps until they get that discipline down.
So it's going to be a run here by Waltham, and that's the
clock starts up again. Renaud steps back, looking towards the middle, and he hits his man, and he's still going, only tackled at the 40-yard line. Noah Foy, once again, his second reception of the game. And that cuts down the penalty. So a couple of times they've redeemed themselves for the penalty, but still got to stop these penalties.
We saw this before too with Winchester. They're able to snag a pass in between two linebackers, and basically forces the quarterback, because now the quarterback can't see the receiver, so it basically forces them to guess and place a exact corner as to where their receiver is.
Now Waltham trying to hurry it up a little. Renaud's just going to hand it off to Connolly this time up the left side. Stopped just around the first down marker. It looks like it's going to be around third down in inches. So we'll see what the play call is here. If I'm Waltham, I'm just going to go for something simple like a QB sneak just to get that 1 yard. They don't have the first down. If they try something too fancy like a pass, they could bring up fourth, which is dangerous. And they're going to go into gun formation.
That's unusual.
Shotgun. He's going to hand it off through the middle, and he gets a hole, and he'll get the first down, and he keeps on his feet. He's still going, and he's only brought down at the 23-yard line. That's another thing that's been going on in the second half. Winchester's been struggling to make the tackles. Waltham just breaking tackle after tackle. Takes about three people to bring one man down.
Yeah, Connolly is a force to be reckoned with here. He's been blazing through the defense so far.
He's had a great game so far, Ty Connolly. Number three for the Waltham Hawks. Winchester's shifting their defensive formation, and about three people on the defensive line just jumped at the same time. That's going to be encroachment, bringing up first and 5.
Now, Nikhil, we're in a very similar situation we've seen a bunch of times before, and we've seen Winchester both stop and let the Hawks go.
They're in the red zone already.
Yeah. So, if I was Winchester here, I'd focus on going for the man coverage.
It's a handoff to Connolly. Connolly stopped in the backfield. A great defensive play being brought down by Paddy Galvin. Once again, Paddy Galvin, of course, has been all over the defense all night. Has a bunch of tackles.
Now, if I was Dabowski, I'd want to see that more. I would want to see these stops play a lot more freely. The linemen are the key
second
in stopping Connolly. If the linemen can get around the offensive, then they're able to stop Connolly.
That brings up second down and 4 for Waltham. They're going to drop back, going for a pass to the outside, and it's overthrown. The intended receiver being Landon Foster.
Intended for Foster.
Number 17 for Waltham, the junior at Waltham High School. That brings up third down and 4 with just about 10 seconds to go in the third quarter, so they will have to run this play. Now we'll see if they convert it. Last time they've had a fourth down in this area, instead of punting or kicking, they've gone for it twice. So if it does become fourth down and they do intend to go for it,
I'm hoping it's ambitious, as always. But knowing, judging by the looks of it, it looks like it's going to be a think, of some kind, and Winston is trying to adapt to it.
In shotgun formation, it's a QB run up the middle, and he has space, and he's still going. Dodges a man to the outside, into the end zone. Touchdown, that is a touchdown, Waltham Hawks, for not doing it himself, making up for the two picks, scoring for Waltham, and they go up 16-6. Nearing the end of the third quarter, so everything in the second half has gone to shreds for Winchester. They came into the half up 6-3, but now it's 16-6 going into the fourth quarter, just about. Now Ramirez back onto the field, number 11, kicker for Waltham.
Ramirez, two for two
on his kicks today. He had the extra point, and he had the short field goal.
Now, what I'm noticing here with Winchester is that they're just going for the wrong placement in terms of where to tackle somebody. Is if I was a lineman, I was stopping Connolly, I would just go for the hip. That's how you tackle somebody.
Snap is down, kick is up, and it is good.
The extra point is good.
And that makes it 17-6, Waltham. Winchester now down by two scores. So despite all the penalties, Waltham coming in the clutch. And now they have two touchdowns.
And Winchester has the opportunity to come back from this.
That's the end of the third quarter.
They need to pull off a good comeback. They're down by 11 points.
And they'll just run the clock here and quickly just say that's the end of the third quarter. So we'll be back in a second as Waltham kicks it off to Winchester to begin the fourth.
Fourth quarter, 17-6 Waltham.
Is set to kick off for Waltham. Wilson and Goodrich back deep for Winchester. Goodrich on the return for Winchester.
And Goodrich is going to be in the backfield this time alongside Lowenstein. They're in shotgun formation. They got two on the left, two on the right.
Seems to be a man coverage here by Waltham, so they're anticipating a run.
He's going for a quick pass to Wilson on the outside. Wilson down to the 40-yard line. Brings up second down and three. So they got to just do more of that. And moreover than like taking those deep passes where Lowenstein's really not been hitting the throws, they got to start just taking those short passes because also the run game has started to slow down. It started off great, but now it's slowing down. The offensive line's getting gassed. They need a break from giving up the holes. They just need to hold their ground as they do in the passing game. Now it looks like Waltham's showing blitz. There's registry on the outside. Now he's going to back up. Goodrich, it was a fake handoff. Lowenstein keeps it. He's swarmed by multiple Hawks, but he's going to get around the first line-ish area, and that will be a first down, Winchester red and black.
Alex Cabral on the tackle for Waltham.
Now here's the thing with So
that is good for a red and black first down.
It's Goodrich versus Connolly in this case. You have
running back versus running back. Yep.
Yeah, you have two running backs. They're both extremely good and extremely viable. One of them, Connolly, he has the brains and he has the feet. He has the foot. He has the ability to move and he knows what he's doing. Goodrich has those abilities, but his main focus is that he doesn't go down without a fight. He will persevere and he will pursue anything.
You got two receivers on the outside and a bunch of people lined up. It'll be a toss to Wilson. He fumbled it, and he's running backwards the wrong way, and he's dragged down. There's a horse collar tackle. That should be a penalty, but there's not going to be a flag on the field. And it's a huge loss for Winchester. Looked like he was taken down with the horse collar tackle, which is a tackle using, like, the back of the collar of the jersey, which is, of course, prohibited. Not going to be called, meaning the refs either didn't see it, my eyes deceived me.
Yeah, I also saw that horse collar tackle right there. I'm a bit surprised they didn't call that. They probably should.
So that brings up second down and really long. Second down and 21. They got three receivers on the right side. Looks like they are going to go for a pass.
So, yeah, it looks like it's a pass on. It looks like it's a pass on Winchester.
Fake handoff looking, and he's got Schlesinger. Schlesinger through the hole, and he's decked at the 40-yard line. The senior at Winchester High School, Will Schlesinger, number 17 on the reception. As I call him, Slushy.
Now, you notice that the line was in a I'd put the line in a more pocket formation because then the pocket collapses hard. It's harder to collapse. And
so that brings up third down and 13. Because this is going to be tough for the Winchester red and black. They're going to have to go for the 13 yards here, or they're putting themselves in a big pickle.
Yeah, it is a bit of a predicament that Winchester's in. I would say the chances are pretty low on success, but hey, you still got, there's still opportunity. Lowenstein is, it looks like it's going to be a pass here.
Looking for Goodrich, short, but he's not going to go anywhere. It's going to be down at the 45-yard line. Goodrich. Brings up fourth down and 9.
It looks like Goodrich is trying to go for it.
And the punting unit's going to come on here to punt the ball away to Waltham.
Fourth down and 9 for Winchester. Conley and registry back.
I'm actually surprised. It's getting a bit late, so pretty soon they are not going to be able to punt it anymore. They're going to have to go for it, or the game's going to get out of reach.
Yeah, we only have about nine minutes left in the entire game. 6-7-7.
Punts back, and Core's kick is up high. Going to fall down around the 30, and it's just caught in a fair catch at the 31-yard line. So Waltham's going to have 70 yards to go to the opposing goal line.
Now, if I was Waltham here, my goal is you want to prioritize. Like, you may be on the offensive end, but your goal is very simple. It's to go for more runs because the runs take out the clock.
Yep, you want to run the clock down so that you win the game, of course.
Yeah, running the clock down will eventually win the timeout because every time a run is cast, then the timer still goes.
So an injury update. Goes. Looks like Patty Galvin just limped off the field. He's made a bunch of good defensive plays for Winchester, so that's going to be a big loss. Now a run from Connolly again bursts through a hole in the middle, and he gets the first down. Connolly has been running all over the red and black.
But Patty Galvin was also one of the big rivals of Connolly. So Connolly is... It's going to be give me a bit of a challenge with that Patty Galvin.
Trying the hard count a little. The coach trying to tell him something. He's trying to switch up the play real quick. Looks like they're just running the clock. He hands it off again to Connolly, who has another hole up the right side. He's hit the first down again. All the way to the 44-yard line. So the Winchester Red and Blacks
defensive line starting to struggle here, giving up hole after hole. Well, of course, you can't forget to give credit to Waltham's offensive line. They've been giving them the holes, but...
Yeah, the line is definitely going to be...
They're going to start...
It has been, since the course of the game, a big part.
They're going to start stacking the box, as they say. Get a couple of linebackers in there to prevent the short runs.
They're definitely stacking the boxes here. Wow, that's a lot of linebackers.
And another run up the right side. There's plenty of open space for Connolly to run through the defense. That's the third 10-yard carry from Connolly in a row. So he's doing his job. He's running all over Winchester.
Yeah, it's short drives like this from Waltham that's stopping Winchester. But in what I would say here is the smart thing for us to do is to sacrifice the linebackers in place for linemen. You still want to have that safety there in the case that it's a pass and it's a fade to Connolly, but you still want to have the linebackers going as linemen.
Now another run from Connolly up the middle, and he gets another first down. That's four 10-yard runs in a row. And if I'm Dombowski, I'm going to be worried right now. Your defense needs a breather. I'd consider calling a timeout here. Just let them have the breather. Or this is going to get out of hand real quick. Almost the entire Winchester student section has just gotten up to leave. Fans already upset.
First down for the Hawks.
Okay, it looks like here it's going to be... I believe that Winchester's trying to anticipate another run by Connolly, as it probably is, because Connolly's in the backfield. But it could be a pass here, judging by that to be man coverage. So hopefully we can see more QB action, but it's most likely going to be into Connolly, knowing by my observations.
Another handoff to Connolly through the right side. George's past one defender and dives for the first down near the 10-yard line. It's about 60 yards and just pure running from number three, Ty Connolly. Now, he needs a breather at some point, so we're likely going to see a switch in play eventually.
Yeah, you're inevitably going to see, because Connolly's been caning. He's been the big bulk of the team. He's been caning, he's been driving down this field by himself, and that's amazing to see. The linemen also are there, and they're making the game for him. So, from the linemen, Connolly's able to maneuver through and weave through the Winchester defense.
There's Connolly again on the right side, and he's finally tackled from behind without getting a first down. That brings up a second down. Chasing him on the play was Patty Galvin. Galvin having come back in after the short injury.
Patty Galvin, last tackle for Winchester.
But they're already inside the 10-yard line.
Seven for the Hawks.
Best thing you can do if you're Winchester here is just hold them and force them to kick a field goal and go for two quick drives. But this is going to be tough for the red and black.
Yeah,
if Waltham scores here, it's essentially over. You don't stand a chance unless you have about three miracles go your way.
I don't think that Winchester has the best chances of winning here. But they do have the opportunity to practice and test some of their players.
Steps back, and Connolly is going to get stopped at the line again. So this brings up third down.
Patty Galvin on attack.
And you have to think they're going to run again.
Now, I'm expecting from Winchester here, because just the fact there's only about four and a half minutes left, and time's ticking as we speak. I'm guessing that Winchester, because they're at 37, so they probably could stop for a field goal. I'd say the best thing to do is a blitz. Straight up, full-on blitz, because it's going to be run by Connolly for the touchdown. Just go for it. There's 4 minutes left. Let's do it.
Third down and long for the Waltham Hawks inside the red zone of the Winchester red and black. High snap, and it's handed off to Connolly, and he's dragged down before the first down line. So it brings up fourth down, and it begs the question, what do you do if you're the Waltham coach? Do you go for it? Do you send out the kicking unit? And it looks like they've already answered my question. There comes Ramirez, the kicking.
I think that Waltham is now confident at this point that they can straight that they can practically just kick for a field goal, get 20 points, 26. That prevents Winchester from going for two touchdowns and getting those points. Because even with his, the only way that this game could go on in terms of Winchester's favor is by them scoring 2 points, getting 2 point conversions getting touchdowns both with extra points two touchdowns with one being a 2 point conversion. Those are your only two options in winning the game, and that requires two drives down the field with Waltham trying to stop you. So that means Winchester needs to have two flawless drives in 3 minutes. That's a hard possibility.
So Waltham's kicker Ramirez, who's been perfect on it, they makes this. They go up 26. So Winchester would be down by two touchdowns and extra points. Of course, Winchester actually hasn't made a single kick today. They've had two kicks blocked. They had one that was missed. And, of course, they had those special teams, the punting mishaps earlier. Waltham has been flawless on special teams. Let's see if they keep that streak going on the day for this 26-yard attempt from Ramirez. Snap is down, and it was shanked, and it's missed wide right. The snap was a bit high for the holder. He couldn't bring it down in time, and it's missed wide right.
That raises the possibility. That raises the stakes a little bit. It may not seem the greatest hope for Winchester, but that still gives Winchester the opportunity to try to make the drive down.
So if you're Winchester here, what I do is you just go down the field real quick, score a field goal, and now you're down by one possession. You gotta hold firm on Waltham, try to get the ball back with like less than a minute to go. Then you have a slight chance. It's up to Dembo to see what he wants to do.
I think Coach Nebowski is going to try to do exactly what you're doing, what you're thinking, Nikhil. I think he's going to try to go for a field goal with Kieran Kaur, and then he's going to back it up with a hopeful touchdown with a two-point conversion. But it all depends on that conversion right there. If they're able to get that two-point conversion, you bring it into overtime. And if you bring it into overtime, the first touchdown that gets it wins.
Of course, we have not seen an overtime in the 2 years we've been covering this. There was that great thriller last year, the Thanksgiving football game between Winchester and Woburn. The Lowenstein steps back. The pressure's coming. He escapes a tackle, and he just runs up the middle for no gain. And this will keep the clock running. And now there's a flag that flies late. And Wilson's going to limp off Winchester's number one receiving target. Dembo, Coach Dembowski, not happy. Let's see what the flag's going to be. And it's going to be a penalty on Winchester. It's going to be a penalty on Waltham, and Winchester will move up to the 35-yard line. Now,
unsportsmanlike first down, Winchester.
An unsportsmanlike penalty on Waltham, so they've still been undisciplined, giving Winchester free yardage, but their top receivers just checked out of the game, so they got to figure out who to throw to here.
See, now Wilson's gone. It's
and another penalty. Flags fly Waltham once again. It's going to be on Waltham again, this time for encroachment. And they're just giving Winchester free yards. Now they're up to the 40-yard line. Still have 60 yards to go. Down by two scores. They got to hurry it up here. Go for some deep balls.
Do you think it's possible, Nikhil, that they could give up enough penalties to...
Now Lowenstein steps back. He's looking. And he hits his man up the middle. Dylan Keough getting his first reception of the night. Getting some positive yards. And there's a flag in the backfield again. Waltham taking another silly penalty. Let's see what it was. Two flags flew. There was an altercation in the back between Scott Richardson of Waltham and one of the linemen for Winchester. They're offsetting fouls, so it's going to negate any sort of loss or gain.
It looks like it's just going to be penalties and Dylan Keough that bring him down the field. That's good to see Dylan Keough making his first drive.
Lowenstein steps back, pump fakes. Now he's going deep on the left side, and it's just over Akira's head. That'll bring up second down, just under 3 minutes to go. He wanted the deep shot. He saw one-on-one coverage. Saw Akira being covered by Landon Foster.
And Akira, the only problem is one-on-one
slightly
coverage
overthrown.
Is when you're a quarterback, you want to make sure the linebacker, the cornerback, whoever it is that's covering the receiver on one-on-one coverage, is not in front. If he's in front, that gives him prime opportunity to go for the catch. You want him to be in the behind the receiver. Then you can go for a much easier catch and then go for it. It looks like it's going to be a zone coverage here.
Lowenstein steps back. He's going deep to the left side again, and it's going to be picked off by Waltham, and that should seal the deal here.
Lowenstein passes intercepted.
He threw it in the same direction, but this time Akira wasn't there. Dylan Keough was in the area.
So there's another pass.
Ball was intercepted by Edwin Ramirez.
And it's going to be Edwin Ramirez, the kicker, who intercepted the ball, which should lead Waltham to now just run the clock out and call it a night for this football game.
Yeah, it's practically the night for this football game. 3 minutes left to go. It's a nice, relaxing night in Henry Nolan Stadium. Stars are already up. It's a chill night. It's a relaxing night.
If you're Winchester, all you can hope for is something like the Meadowlands Miracle. Miracle from the 80s, where a team that was trying to run out the clock fumbled the ball. Very unlikely chance of that happening. Connolly not going to make much of a gain, but he's going to get his intended goal of just running the clock now.
Brian Harrison on the tackle for Winchester.
Looks like Coach Dombowski is not going to call his timeouts. I think he's accepted at this point that this game is essentially over.
Yeah, I don't think that they can come back from this game, unfortunately. But there's still the opportunity to try some things out, experiment. But it seems like they're just still going for a man coverage and all that. All that Waltham's doing is running with Connolly. So
switching up the plate real quick was Renaud, the quarterback.
It's like
snaps a bit high, but he gives it off to Connolly again, who's not getting anywhere since the last drive where he got a bunch of yards. He hasn't gone any sort of yardage. And the clock will continue to run. And now Winchester takes a timeout. So that brings up third down and a timeout by Coach Dombowski.
I think we're just tired at this point. It's 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter. It's late at night. The moon's already out. It's already relaxed. I think that Winchester's calling it a game. But if I were them with the 2 minutes I had, if I was playing this game with the intent of winning, which I probably wouldn't, then I would try to rely on the defense going for the shoulders and the chest.
All they can really do here is try to stop this, maybe call another timeout. Then you have no timeouts left, so you're going to have to play off of a quick two-minute drill and an onside kick, which is very unlikely, but it's high school football. Anything can realistically happen.
Yeah, it is. Looks like they're in a huddle right now. I would assume that Dabowski is trying to basically just close up the case, close it up.
But if Waltham does get the first down on this play, then the game will be essentially over.
Yeah. If Waltham gets the first down here, then the game's done. It's
a noticeable player missing is Patty Galvin. He's going to stay on the sideline for this big play, just getting some rest now. He's been the defensive player of the night so far for Winchester Red and Black.
Patty Gowan has been their best source of stopping the run game.
Now Connolly is going to run up the middle again. He's going to get stuffed, and you'd expect them to call their final timeout here to stop the clock. And Dombowski is looking the other way. He's not calling a timeout. So they're just going to let the clock run out here. They're going to punt it, and they're going to get a couple of heaves from Winchester.
So Winchester's already given up. Looks like Dombowski is showing them some sort of paper. It might be the playbook.
Ramirez into punt for Waltham.
Looks like Winchester is swapping in their
special teams units coming on.
Winchester.
And looks like they're sending up everyone close to try to block the kick. So Waltham's going to go for a safe formation. If they block the kick here, literally everyone has gone up to block the kick.
Wow. Oh, my Lord.
It's not something you see every day.
It's very ambitious. I'm intrigued. I mean, like, having this coverage is
and the
really
snap
rare.
Is a bit high, but it'll be a safe punt to around midfield where it'll bounce. And it'll be picked up by Winchester and dragged down by the Waltham defender.
And also, Winchester player. So it looks like they're at their own 46.
Number 90, that is Evan Geyer, the senior at Winchester High School.
Geyer on the return for Winchester.
So 51 seconds to go. Game's essentially over. Maybe take a couple of deep shots here. Just try. Why not? Test Lowenstein's arm out. We haven't seen him make too many deep throws. Yeah. The couple of deep throws he has made, he's overthrown most of them.
Yeah, unfortunately, correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think I saw him too much throwing in practice. I saw him mainly going for screen passes and stuff like that. I want to see what he's like when he's chucking it deep, when he's throwing it deep. I also want to see a bit of Jackson Drill in the field. He's the other quarterback that we haven't seen much of in the game recently. He's been involved in a couple of plays towards the end zone.
Now Lowenstein stepping back. He's looking for Wilson, and he gets 2 feet down. A great toe-tapping catch. 45 seconds to go. Brings Winchester up to the 40-yard line. Now they have 40 yards to go. They have to go very quickly if they want to even get an onside kickoff. And the clock's going to continue running. Now they got to hurry up. They got to snap the ball, or they're going to run out of time. Lowenstein shifting Goodrich. Hands it off, fakes it, and blitz up the middle. He's going to go quickly to the outside to Wilson, and Wilson will just step out of bounds near the 31-yard line. That will stop the clock for a brief second. Let them get a breather.
Going to bring up second down and about five.
Looks like Winchester's already huddling up for the end. Same with Waltham. Nice getting a bit colder. I'd say that this game is about done. It looks like Waltham's going for another bit of man coverage. Waltham's been particularly adamant on having their man coverage and making sure that, we don't want the receiver.
Now Lowenstein stepping back. He's going for the end zone for Costello, and he's caught it out of bounds. So that'll be an incomplete pass. Waltham player, good little celebration, saying that incomplete. That was number 13 on the coverage, Rasheed Marshall once again. He's been on Ben Wilson all night. Coach Dombowski having a strict word with Costello now.
Yeah, Rasheed has been on point so far. He's covered Ben Wilson, he's covered Ben Costello, and he's done his job. He's able to maneuver around Wilson, maneuver around the receivers, and basically get in front of them without them.
So third down and short, Lowenstein dropping back. He's going across the middle, and it's intercepted again. That's his second interception of the game. And that should seal the deal in the night. The Waltham players and the Winchester players now getting heated a bit. They're pushing and shoving each other. Words are being exchanged. And that will... Flags are now flying. Silly to take these penalties now. The game's already almost over. You don't need to take them. They're going to be offsetting penalties for unsportsmanlike conduct on each team after the play.
Yeah, I don't see how this game could... I don't see how this game could end anyway. I feel like there's not really anything else you could do here. I'm pretty sure it is game. Waltham's already calling it game with their arm movements, already made some exchanges, and it looks like Winchester's going on the field with the coach. It looks like it's about maybe one more play to close the book off. Tonight has been one hell of a night. It's been one hell of a game from dawn to dusk. And I would say that overall Winchester has definitely improved from last year. It's been great seeing them get better with the passing and the running game. They may have lost some great players like Doucette and Patty Galvin, but they're able to persevere with Goodrich and Wilson and Lowenstein.
Waltham now in victory formation to close out the game. He takes a knee, and that should do it on the night. Your final score from the Knowlton Turf is 17-6. Waltham, Winchester loses their home opener. Winchester now goes to 1-1, and Waltham improves to 2-0. Signing off from the field is me, Nikhil Karthikeyan. Alongside me is Jason Termini and the rest of our camera crew, Noah Mulcahy and Andrew Termini.
Wonderful. We hope you have a wonderful night. This has been Jason Termini, and tonight has been, and we hope you enjoy the rest of your night. Have a wonderful weekend here in Harry Knowlton Stadium. Thank you very much, and have a good night.